So in my daily tip number 177 for PLSQL, I wrote, overloading is a fantastic feature, but you should never have to use name notation to distinguish between overloadings. One person asked, well, what are you talking about? Let's find out. So overloading is a situation where you can have more than one subprogram with the same name. Here we go. I've got a sales package, two procedures named calc total. Each of them take a single parameter of type string. One of them has a parameter named zone in, one region in. The zone version displays zone. The region version displays region. Now, if I try to compile this code, Oracle says, cool, everything's fine, you got a valid package. The question then becomes, how can I call this code? Let me count the ways. There aren't that many. So, let's first of all try to call it, passing a string, the zone string. It should use the zone version, right? Run my code, kaboom! PLS 307, too many declarations of calc total match this call. What's the problem? Well, we know it's a zone, it's clear looking at it, it's a zone. But of course, from the standpoint of the compiler, it can't distinguish between two different strings in the parameter list. We know it's a zone string, but all Oracle sees is it's a string. So it fails to be able to execute or find the match and execute the right one. However, if I switch to name notation, so now I'm explicitly saying this string goes with this parameter, the zone in parameter, using my association symbol equal greater than, then I can run my code. No problem. So here's an example where my overloading is designed such that the only way I can call one of these two subprograms is by using name notation. Now, name notation is a great feature and it makes your code more readable. And it's some people say that you should always use name notation. It's a fine thing to do. The problem is most of us don't do that. And the second problem is that you should never design your packages and your overloading so that the only way that you can run your code is by using name notation. That's just a bit of a steep climb to expect our co-users to do. So that's the point of tip number 177. Overload, please overload, but make sure you overload in such a way that you never have to use name notation to get the job done. Thanks for joining me. Happy PL SQL coding.